could install here on e-water level before we put the frame that we have already installed on the wall of this canal. Is actually the head of an irrigation canal, so the main canal of Chefura. So we have installed it in order to put this cage inside, as you see here. This frame will secure the diver that we will put inside this cage here. So what I will do now is to remove this the cage. This I will do it like that. I remove all this. As you see, and you have to prepare this in the concrete wall before you bring all the system. This is the diver, e-water level. Actually, the real sensor is here, rather. But you have this stick. That is very handy if you want to put the diver inside an irrigation canal, for example. And we know that in small irrigation canals, the water layer is not more than a few tens of centimeters. So you can put this, and then you connect. You connect this side, the top of this e-water level, the top here, you connect it to a computer in order to program or to schedule at what times and what initial temperature you can make the measurements. So this is done by connecting this side of the diver to the computer. And for that, you will find in the market different proposals for equipment, for the connection, the connectivity. This is a USB connector that is supposed to be used here. You put this inside here, and then you connect the oversight to the USB port of the computer. But I must tell you that this one is not good, because there is a small stick inside here that is supposed to go with this the third hole. This small stick very often will break. And then we use this and it's not very good. So better to avoid it. Try rather to have this double connector in two parts. One is called the USB cable. That is indeed this one, the USB cable. And it's called the diver USB interface. As you can see here, diver USB interface. And you have this other one that you will connect first. So I will put the diver itself here. You have the second one that will make the connection of this USB part that's going to the computer and the diver itself. The thing that is interesting in this cable is that here you have a better, much better connector to the top of your e-water level. This small hole, this small stick is going to the third hole here, as you can see. So you put this inside, and then it stick together, and then you can now fix all things together like this. And then you can connect to the computer. So this way, and then stick it like that, and then you screw it. And it's okay. Now the next thing to do is to connect this to the computer, and there is a small program that is called LDM, Logger Data Management, and this program can allow you to schedule the pace at which you will make your measurements, the frequency of the measurements, and insert into the diver all initial values. And one thing we should pay attention to is that if you fix this, if you put this cable to the computer, the program will show will display you at what communication port. If you go to, you can see it now on the screen, but if you go to the logger settings, you can see it's rather of communication management, application management. If you go there, application management, you can see there is a line called selected COM port, and the diver COM should display here. One thing you should pay attention to is that this COM must be, the number of the COM must be smaller than 10. Otherwise, the diver, if you have COM, for example, 25, the diver, the program will not be able to communicate with the diver. And you can change that inside window if you go to system and you look at the communication port and you assign to this one, the USB port, you assign something like 2 or 3, or numbers like that. So what I will do is to check what is inside now, and then I empty everything and put my measurement time, for example.
So I will
now look at inside the diver using this LDM, Logger Data Management Program, and then what I will do in the case of this irrigation canal, in which you can see the water levels are not so high. So let's say generally it will be less than 40 centimeters, as you can see here. And then I can make the measurements of this every 6 hours. So during the growing season, here it's an irrigation scheme of rice. During the growing season, I will make every day, let's say 4 measurements. Yeah, for example, here I have started, it's better to connect first your diver to the computer before you start the program LDM. At the beginning, like you can see here, it said, the program said that port not present in hardware has been replaced by COM1. COM1 is a good one. Then I can continue. If it had been said here that this one is COM25, then I have to go to Windows system, and then the management of the system and change the number there. But this one is okay.
Okay, inside here, I already have a few data that you can see on the screen for Tiefura, 7th of February 2013, the start time and the end time. I have just one measurement here. And here is a place I can, if you look at the program, we cannot explain all the details here. Then you can input your settings for the diver. Measurement tab. Now if I go to logger settings, then on the bottom, not only in the middle, I see the sensor channel settings here, but on the bottom here, you can see logger status started. And this is very important, because you can stop it also. You can stop it. If you stop it, then your diver is not measuring anything. It's very good to refer to the guides, the guidebook, the book, reference book of this program. Is to put the stick, the e-water level, inside the cage that we see here, and then I will lock the top here. I will lock it with a screw, with a screw. And when I put inside, then I will put this screw in order to maintain the diver in a vertical position, that it will be suspended inside. So this screw will go like this in this hole, and then enters inside this hole, and the other one, the second one, then the second one is put here. So the diver will be suspended inside. This is in order to facilitate the entrance of the water flow inside the cage, so that the diver itself will be submerged inside, and then make the measure. It will measure the water level in a vertical direction above the diver itself. And this is registered, recorded inside, because there is a memory. And there is here, I have not shown it, there is a battery here, a rechargeable battery, that will maintain. And then this can be, for the case of the e-water level, this can be here for 1 year, even 2 months. Yeah, one thing we should not forget is that this one is optical sensor buttons here. Huh? And then it's always good in order to protect it against the light, so that not to have too much battery consumption, to close this, to cover it with this this plastic cover. And then I can insert inside now. I think it's in the hole. Then I would take the over screw, and then here, then I would screw it also. Here. And then it will remain suspended inside. Then I take the screwdriver. This then is the screwdriver can normally put it inside. This one also here. Yeah, it seems that this one is not well, very well positioned. Can I change maybe? Like this. That's okay. And then it's inside. And what I will do now is just I'll be careful that so as to have this holes in the direction of the flow, so that the flow can enter easily. And from time to time I have to come and also clean, because you can have mud inside. Then I put this here in the key, in the frame that I've already constructed in. Will rest on the bottom, but actually I did a small hole there after measuring the level and the elevation of the bottom of the canal. And after I will come and close this so that children will not play with it and spoil the diamond. So I can put that in place now. Yeah, that's okay. And then this one. The fact that I have installed here the e-water level means that I have actually, because this one has only the ability to measure the water level with the temperature associated with it. But actually, a little bit farther there is an hydraulic structure, that is a wheel that I'm going to use in order to calculate the discharge. If I have the discharge, and since this one is giving also the time, the discharge, the water level, then I can, the discharge and the time, then I can calculate the water volume that has been consumed by the pump. This is the area where you have a weir. And the e-water level, as you can see, the bug there was fixed. The water level measured from this e-water level will be used with the law of the discharge, the formula of discharge of this wear in order to compute the discharge. And then we can have also the volume of water used by the irrigation scheme located downstream this canal.